Biggest thing, you want to make sure the chest is ready to go because it's going to be a lot of volume today. All right, guys, the purpose of today's workout, chest and back, antagonistic muscle group. So as one contracts, the other one's being stretched. I like doing this because as I'm doing a back exercise, my chest is recovering and vice versa. So we're gonna start off bench press with a medium grip. We're gonna go 12, 10, 8, 6, 4 on the bench press. We're gonna be supersetting it with a pull-up. Now, we're gonna be doing some variations on the pull-up. So this first one, we're gonna do wide grip pull-up. We're gonna talk more about that, but we're gonna go 15, 12, 10, 8, 8. The last two are gonna be weighted. So basically, with every pull-up that we do, if you can do body weight for at least 10, then I want you to be able to actually, if you can do, you have to be able to at least do 10 before you can start adding weight. If you can't do 10, substitute that for a lat pull down. Once you can do at least, I would say, your body weight on a lat pull down for 8, then move over and start doing pull-ups.
Biggest thing, you wanna make sure the chest is ready to go because it's gonna be a lot of volume today. Last thing you wanna do, blow a pec out. I've been spotting a guy, 405, tore his pec. It's not a pretty sight.
Like I thought Aladdin when the genie's talking about bringing people from the dead. I don't like doing it.
You're a monster, man.
It's like I've been doing this since you were 12.
I know, right? It's crazy. I wonder how old you would be then, right?
I'd be 34. Warming up with two sets of 15, but even a warm up, we're setting our shoulder girdle up in a way that is gonna best focus on the chest. So the lats down and back, pretend you're bending that bar. And from there, we're gonna be pushing up. We got 15 reps on pull-ups. Starting it off, working set number one. 15 reps, trying to keep the elbows as wide as I can. What that does, it's gonna force my chest to stay nice and high rather than caving. This is gonna really recruit a lot of back into this movement. So if we let our arms go more here like we would a neutral grip, that's fine. It's gonna work a little bit lower on the lats. So as we go wider here, it's gonna work a little bit more upper back. 15 reps. The warm up never hurt anyone, right? Friday night, only the big dogs come in and work out. Medium grip, so I'd say this is wide, medium, close, medium here. For me, it's about my thumbs are on the rough part. Twelve reps, just baby weight. I barely got 15 last time. Time to rock and roll.
Come on, big dog, you got one more.
Okay.
Atta boy. Hey. Swole, mate.
I think I need to go back to the old notebook. I was going through my storage unit the other day. Not my storage unit, my office. And just had piles of old workout journals. And I was like, oh, those were the days. Put the phone away, write down what you got that day. And then sets, reps, how you felt when you failed. Just write down whatever we have in the app in your journal. I know that's a lot of different steps, but I get too distracted. Arnold didn't have a cell phone he had to worry about. Thank you.
guys are like me, you count and breathe at the same time. But a lot of times, I'll like count the five, and then I count down. I don't know, it's weird. Moving up, a little bit less girly of a color. Went from pink to blue. This one is 12 kg or 26 pounds. We got 10 pull-ups. 10 pull-ups, wide. Last time weren't wide enough. As it gets heavier, you're gonna wanna let those elbows cheat. It's only human. Try to keep those elbows nice and wide. Lower back arch. Turn into a rest pause set. Bit off a little bit more than I could chew. Should have gone 20. I'm gonna stay here. Biggest thing you guys will notice when you start training like this is doing the superset. It's like cardio super taxing. So we're hitting 15 reps, bouncing back, hitting 12, hitting 8. You're not taking a lot of rest time. Taking about a minute to a minute and a half in between. So you start noticing, oh, I'm breathing a little bit more, like my heart rate's up, considering when I just do chest or just do back and rest. All right, breathing hard. Our next superset, we're on incline. So I'm doing a Smith machine on this. I don't have anyone spotting me. This is a great little tool. If you don't have a spot, Smith machine works great. And I also kind of like it for chest. Now, we're gonna be doing a free weight movement, which we did. We're gonna also be doing dumbbells here later on. And that's why a Smith machine is nice, because it kind of puts you in a fixed position here. So really, we're gonna be focusing on that upper pec. Incline, 15, 12, 15, 12, 10, 8, 8. Five sets, supersetting that with chin-ups, 15, 12, 10, 8, 8 on here. So about a minute in between hand. If you're not using your typical weight that you are used to, it's okay. We're introducing something new, so it's gonna feel a little bit different, but stick to that 1 to 1 minute 30 rest time. All right, again, this is medium grip here. So almost where the bar starts going smooth and then about another inch. It's been a minute since I've done 15 reps on anything. So on the incline, instead of coming nipple height, I'm almost just below the chin. So it's almost like a guillotine press. I was probably a little bit too close to the chin, so I'm gonna push the seat back about an inch. A little bit of bicep coming in there. High volume. Same principles apply for this. We set the shoulder blades, and then we're in a fixed position here, so it's gonna be a little bit harder to get that scooping motion. But the nice thing is you kind of push against the bar, almost try to push it back, really working that upper pec. Never lie. Mm-hmm.
All right, next superset, dumbbell incline. I think with these, it's really easy to lose that mind muscle in your chest and really not to even be working the chest. If you let those shoulders round and then you really just focus on touching the dumbbell instead of trying to touch your elbows. When all of a sudden we're touching dumbbells, it's putting a lot more stress on that anterior delt because your elbow stays wide and it actually never fully gets into that contracted position where we're extending our elbow, or not extending, we're actually bringing the elbow closer into the body. Many times our elbows are close, that chest is activated. So think of that when you're doing these. We're gonna keep the arms almost completely straight, and again, just squeeze at the top, lower back down under control. Here, again, chest is nice and high the entire time. I'm not like this ever. Chest is nice and high. And then trying to touch the elbows. Here's a bad rep right here. It's a lot of anterior delt work. So straighten it out at the top. At the bottom, if you want to bend your elbows, that's fine. But at the top, you need to try to touch those elbows. For the record, I'm done trying to make y'all comfortable. For the record, you ain't trying to grow, then it's done for you. For the record, lab on me going all the way. For the record, ain't trying to link no time. Right. T-bar rows. We got 12, 10, 8, 6 on here. We're supersetting 12, 10, 8, 6. Supersetting again, that push pull. We're gonna start off with a medium grip row all the way. All the way up. For the record, I'm done trying to make y'all comfortable. For the record, you ain't trying to grow, then it's done for you. For the record, lab on me going all the way. For the record, ain't trying to link no time to waste. One thing you can do in between sets. This is just stretch that chest, stretch those lats, just grabbing something that's about a little bit higher than waist height, and then just leaning back, elongated, and then that chest, just opening it up. Been a little too nice to y'all, now I gotta up price on y'all. Snake eyes on dice for y'all, shoulders on ice for y'all. A6 all the hay, I woke in a bar today, got lost in the ball and A's. I'm flipping the bars, I'm flipping the on record, off record, I still count wins when they got it. On record, off record, I let them take advantage, I was wildin'. On record, off record, deals, tell them talk to Colin for the quote. On record, off record, I still want the act, not the ghost. Oh, everything is going heavy. It's one of those days. Just gotta push through it. Not every day is sunshine and rainbows and butterflies. There's times when that negative voice in your head is a little bit louder than it should be. Outside factors in your life start taking up real estate. When that happens, you really get one of two options. You can feed them, you can listen to them more, or you just say no. You have that alarm when that negative self-talk, or when people start crossing your boundaries, that alarm just says, no, not today. This is my time. This is my time in here. I'm gonna come into the gym and put my headphones on. No one else gets that time. Because if I don't have that time in my life, then I can't be as good as I need to be for other people. This is my time. You don't get it. You have your time, you have your opportunity. You can take it up with, you know, with the assistant. You can take it up with whoever, but right now, this is me, this is my time. I'll talk to you and I'll be nice, I'll love you, no matter what. But right now, this is me. Let's go next superset. All right, we got a bent over barbell row. Now, purpose of this, be bent over rowing. So when we train our back, we have pull downs or pull ups, and then we also have that rowing position. So this is a lat thickness here. So we're gonna be using just wider than a shoulder width grip. We're gonna be bent over almost at 90 degrees. And as we come up, we're just gonna change that angle about 10%. So it's not a lot, but as you row up, you also bring that upper body up just ever so slightly, pulling into the lower abdomen. So anywhere between, I would say, that diaphragm, so right here to right there. The more you pull here, a little bit lower you're gonna do, the more you pull up to the chest, the upper back. So if you pull, if you're up here more, and you pull into your hips, it's gonna be that lower lat, this is gonna be your upper back. So a little bit of variation you can choose from there. On this, like I said, I'm gonna be almost 90 degrees, pulling, it's about that sternum. Like bent over barbell rows to just get you lightheaded. Next set, I'm gonna be wearing a belt. We're gonna belt it up. Before we do that though, we got a chest dip. So we're gonna go show you that right now. Chest dip's gonna be working that lower outside pec. All right, usually dips, we always talk about dips for triceps. Dips for chest, butt goes back, come almost about 45 degrees, legs go up. Turns into almost a pressing position. These two together are an ass kicker. Up so I don't blow out my back.
Nearly took me out.
It nearly took us both out. We're getting closer to the end of this workout. Been a lot of volume. As far as bent over rows go, this is the last set, best damn set. All right, last set, best set for this exercise. Superset, got a good pump going from today. Dumbbell pullovers, supersetted with a row. So the pullover, it's a little bit of a rib cage expansion if you really buy into that sort of thing, because rib cages has some cartilage in there. The idea was by doing a lot of dumbbells, you can stretch your chest, your lats, and make your rib cage bigger. Doing those on a back day or a chest day is acceptable. Today's both, so we're gonna be doing a dumbbell pullover with a seated row, 12, 10, 8, 6 on here, and then we're gonna be finished. It's gonna feel so good. So on this, I'm gonna try to move at a pretty quick pace, about a minute in between. Neither one of these movements is big, heavy compound movements, so getting it done.
Bitch, I got problems, so problems, so problems, so problems, so problems, so problems, I solve them. I run through the money, the pressure be calling. Left on my blessings, I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back. Tell me I'm garbage, I'm going through something, that's why I ain't calling. Phone in progression, that's all that I wanted. A phone in affection, I summon and dub it. Cause bitch, I got problems on problems on problems on problems on problems on problems, I solve them. I run through the money, the pressure be calling. Left on my blessings, I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back. Tell me I'm garbage, I'm going through something, that's why I ain't calling. Phone in progression, that's all that I wanted. A phone in affection, I summon and dub it. Why you be all in my life?
lying about nothing. Why won't you go get you a dollar or something? Don't hang with a nigga who lying for nothing. I see that we different, you riding, I dub them. I don't do discussions on bragging about hundreds. Don't go to your places, I know that they sunken. Don't call me your brother, I barely could trust it. I talk to a shorty, she bagging the bugging. And I'ma need all of my dollars on corporate, so hand me the money, I divvy the pie. I'ma give all of my people a portion to build them a fortune. I'm flipping the ride. I can't be mixing with iffy the vibe. And 40 on 50 is really the time. Why are you all on my phone like you want me?
Sometimes I forget what I say. So it's a good thing we have it written on the wall. Last set, what was this? Best set, here we go. Taking the hundreds for a spin. That felt good. That was one that was just reminiscent of the good old days. Whew. Give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more of these. Again, Monday's trainer, Thursday's a vlog, Sunday's a one take. Whew. If you guys have anything you guys want to see next, let me know. But we're gonna do some of these older, more thought out. Just remember, if there's any message you guys want to take home from this, gym time. Let's get back to having it be our time. So many things, that cell phone, that damn cell phone, family, friends, girlfriend, boyfriend, work, they all require your attention. That can be the rest of your day. Those people can have your attention, but for 2 hours, an hour and a half, an hour, whatever you can give it your all in here. Cut out those distractions because that will pay dividends. If you can invest back into you in here, that'll pay dividends off in your life. So. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. It was a good pump. Bringing it back, old school. Thank you guys for watching.